Now take a look on today's bulletin. The World Health Organization on Wednesday recommended board use of world's first malaria vaccine for children, touting it is a breakthrough the science, child health and malaria control.
The recommendation of the RTS malaria vaccine is based on results from an ongoing pilot program in Ghana, Kenya and Malawi, which begins in 2019. Addressing a press briefing on malaria vaccine recommendations, WHO Director General Tedros Adhanom said that tens of thousands of young lives could be saved every year by using the vaccine in addition to existing tools to prevent malaria. This is a powerful new tool, but like COVID-19 vaccine, it's not the only tool. Vaccination against malaria does not replace or reduce the need of the measures, including bed nets or seeking care for fever, the WHO chief told the media briefing. Recalling his early career as a malaria researcher, Tedros said that he longed for the day that the world would have an effective vaccine against the ancient and terrible diseases.
An 18-year-old opened fire inside a Dallas area high school, leaving for 4 people injured for fleeing, authorities said Wednesday.
The shooting happened at Timberview High School in Arlington, which is part of the Dallas-Fort Worth metropolitan area. Authorities said at a news conference the shooting happened after a fight broke out at the school. Police were searching for the suspected shooter, whom they identified as Timothy George Simpkins. They said he might be driving a 2018 Silver Dodge Charger with license plate PFY6260.
The CCS police has arrested 6 more persons, including the Kingpin Chanduri Venkat Koti Sai Kumar, in connection with multi-core Telugu Academy fixed deposit fraud on Wednesday.
The police official who had arrested for individual earlier said that they suspected the involvement of up to 9 more than persons in the scam. The arrested were identified as Seguri Ramesh alias Ravi, the administrator officer in charge of accounts, M. Sadhana, branch manager of Canara Bank, Chandranagar, Chanduri Venkata Koti Sai Kumar, real estate agent, Nanduri Venkat Raman, Venkateshwar Rao alias Dr. Venkat alias Rajesh, a self-proclaimed RMP doctor and a real estate agent from Kamam district, and Som Shekhar alias Rajkumar, also a real estate agent.
Religious places across Maharashtra will reopen from today, day one of the 9-day Navratri festival, as announced by the Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray's office last month.
All places of worship will reopen from the first day of Navratri, 7th October 2021. While observing to all COVID-19 safety protocols, the CMO had announced in a tweet on September 24. The Thackeray-led government had resisted immense pressure from the opposition Bharatiya Janata Party to announce the reopening of place of worship, even as it is gradually relaxed COVID-19 restriction in the state. Last month, the administration had announced restriction for festivals such as Ganesh Chaturthi and Janmashtami.
Bathukamma, the festivals of colors and melodies that celebrates women well-being in the city on Wednesday.
The celebration of togetherness, a culture and tradition unique to Telangana, saw women coming together with a floral arrangements for 9-day-long festival. In the GHMC limits, Deputy Mayor Moth Srilata Soban Reddy and other cooperators celebrated the festival in their respective wards. Bathukamma songs were played all the venues, with the recent work by music maestro A.R. Rahman and Gautam Vasudev Monan, Alipula Venala, being a favorite at the place where Bathukamma is being celebrated. Women are successfully discharging their duties in various fields apart from the managing their family and homes. May the blessing of Ammavaru always be with them, the mayor said.
That's it for today from me and my team. For more updates, keep watching Crazy News.